Hi there, and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Che. In the late 1980s, a style of rock music began to develop that was and still is recognized for its rhythmic variety and complex time signatures. Some listeners began to describe the music as mathematical. The term math rock was born. It's popular with some bands in Hong Kong too, and one of them is Milos. They'll be with us later. Like math rock, which experiments with alternative ways to create musical constructions, Hong Kong's art platform, Project 21st, also encourages experimentation and research. This year, Project 21st is focusing on the musical experience and the concept of music performance itself. Members of the Zurich-based collective International Totem rehearsed for their performance in Project 21st's Music Is More series of presentations. The site-specific events that make up the series took place in May, June and July.
We try to take music out of concert hall. We also want to go beyond the discipline of music and try to explore the nature of music as a happening, or as an immersive theater, or as something that is related to your daily life.
Berlin, an immersive performance of live music, drama, and video that premiered in Switzerland in 2019, was the first program in the series. For this presentation, the performance area becomes a boat, and the audience members become tourists experiencing a whale-watching tour.
It's a bit imitation of a boat trip. They are sitting into the boat, and then they're traveling with this boat to some location. And lastly, says that We're traveling to see the whales, and then we have the sounds and everything that's kind of connects.
The Hong Kong version of Berlin took place at the Hong Kong Maritime Museum. It's the first music performance to have been presented in the venue. In keeping with the site-specific emphasis of the Music Is More series, the backdrop of Victoria Harbour became a vital part of the whale-watching boat tour. Unlike in a traditional music concert, the audience entered the cabin dining area as passengers. The performers became crew members, introducing safety procedures to the passengers before the tour began.
On a boat tour, often you have some entertainment, and we decided to have a cooking show, for example.
Passion de la musique. Cuisine. Cuisine.
The boat sends signals to attract whales to increase the chance of spotting the creatures. The performers play music that imitates the vocalizations of a whale and also makes sounds with other props.
One of the most frustrating things is when you cannot see animals, so looking for a whale-watching tour, you need to call them. As this crisis that we are all living about climate change and this crisis, the animals are disappearing, no? And so it's about this, I thought it was interesting, this calling, that we are still calling them. And,
what a beautiful story beside this huge city and its rumor to have this silent island. It's a beautiful contradiction to Hong Kong. And it's so close, so it's just one ferry away.
Kasper Koenig is a designer, sound and performance artist who has been living and working in Zurich since 2012. He's particularly interested in transforming everyday objects into musical instruments or sound installations.
I decided to develop a really specific, for this work, the euphonia, and I decided to engage the wind inside the performance as a main actor, maybe, as in Peng Chao being surrounded by wind. So I thought that would be a beautiful thing to do.
In recent years, Koenig has been looking for ways to create large-scale air-powered sound devices from objects such as the wind tunnels commonly used in industrial design. Among his creations is an inflatable wind tunnel, an outdoor installation created in collaboration with artist Florian Dombois. For the collective's Hong Kong presentation, he introduced another instrument that uses wind to produce sound. Built with the help of 3D printing technology, this machine incorporated organ pipes as well as upcycled materials he had found in Peng Chau.
I built this organ in Switzerland, where I live, where I have my workshop. So I find an harmonium, then I started to figure out to power it. This is all 3D printed and mounted and designed by me to make it happen that the belly can actually move. And the valves make sure that the wind is only going in one direction. So it's taking the wind out here and it is getting sucked out there. And then to make sure that if there's no wind, that there's always sound, I made this extra outlet. And if I put it on, you will see there's some wind coming out here, yeah?
Accompanied by two Hong Kong musicians, Koenig took the euphonia to a cafe in Peng Chau for a site-specific music performance. Audiences could experience the sounds produced by the wind as they experienced the beauty of the island.
To emphasize the audience that it's all about winds, I tried to make the fan really visible. I designed the badminton rackets to be wind harps. Found out that the construction sound is very specific here in Hong Kong. So when I hear this da-da-da-da-da-da-da, I on one side thought of a woodpecker, like this sound, type of sound. The more we build, the less nature life we have. So there's a problem. And I wanted to symbolize this by the birds that were going to escape.
The show ended by inviting the audience to participate by blowing to create wind and be part of nature.
Invited everybody to become wind with me, and we did that beautifully, and then I thought that's a beautiful ending.
First introduced to Hong Kong in the 1920s, neon signs became prominent in our streets from the 1950s through the 1980s. In recent years, they've been replaced by cheaper LED lights, but for decades, they were an instantly recognizable symbol of the city around the world. Vital Signs, on show at Tai Kwun, celebrates the craftsmanship and characteristics of Hong Kong's neon signs. Welcome back. instrumental math rock band Milos released the first piece of music, Potato Flower, in 2016. 2 years later, they expanded from a trio to a quartet. This month, they've released a vinyl and a CD that contain all the music they've created so far. And they're here right now to tell us more, including a little bit about what math rock actually is. Okay, members of Milos, welcome to The Works.
Thank you so much.
So let's start. Can you tell us your name and the instruments that you play in the band?
Yeah, I'm Charles and I play guitar in Milos.
I'm Frankie, I play piano in Milos.
I'm Andrew, I play bass in Milos.
I'm the drummer, I'm Mao.
Cool, yeah. Welcome to The Works. So Milos was formed in 2016 and you started as a three-piece, but eventually you became a four-piece in 2018. Maybe tell me a bit about the history. How did the band go from three-piece to a four-piece and so on?
2016, at that time, there are many artists or groups that love to play and love to make their music in their bedroom or in their small studio. Actually, Milos was just like that. And we just want to make our music and then share it, you know, online and then share our music to the world. But after some support and encouragement from our manners or some of our good fans, we decided to change Milos from a project to a band, the real band that do the live performances. And then after a while, we met Frankie. Yeah, Frankie changed a lot of us. And then at the time, Milos became a four-member band.
Right.
Yeah, so I think it's really different between the trial and the four-member bands of Milos.
Mm. The first show that you played as the actual band was in support of a Taiwanese band, right? Can you tell me about that experience? What was that like?
Our first time to have a live performance is has an opening act of a Taiwanese band called Elephant Gym. Mm. At the time, they was having an Asian tour and there was a Hong Kong station. So at the time, Gary from Wireless Music just invited us. Yeah, and they just he just tell me, oh, would you like to have a real show? Do you want to on stage? At the time, me and Mao just said, oh, no, we can't because We just can make our music in our bedroom, but after our discussion, we thought that it would be a great opportunity,
right?
Yeah, or is a great motivation to push us to a real band.
And amazing, from that first show to now, you've played many, many shows, and you've also recently released your debut album. Tell me a bit about this album. What is the concept or idea behind it? And the title, you know, the colon, what does that mean?
Actually, this album called Between. Yeah, and actually this idea is came from Mao. Yeah, because in this album, the song is selected from our works from 2016 to 2020. There is some new song or some entire new song after Frankie's joined our band.
Right.
Yeah, so Mao felt that this album is exit in the past and the present days.
Mm.
So we just thought that this concept is good and we decided to name this album as Between.
Right.
And use the colon to represent our ideas.
And then tell me a bit more about the music. So it's music from 2016 until now. So has the style changed a lot? Also, you know, since Frankie joined as well.
Before me joining the band, they said they used the computer to compose all the music, note by note.
Yeah.
And it was not guitar friendly, right?
Yes. Yeah. We make the music fixed it, and every single note and everything just fixed and arranged it.
Yeah. Right. It's like a robot.
Yeah, we also play along with the click track.
Right.
And the live performance.
It's the live performance. Right.
After me joining in the band, they said they feel like, wow, we are playing music.
Yeah, we finally play the music. Everything.
Right.
Yeah, yes, definitely.
Right. Very exciting.
So we decided to change our method of making music or even the performance. Yeah, after Frankie's joined the band.
Right.
It's really a big difference.
Yeah, in our live performance, we encourage to hear what the members playing instead of just play our parts.
Right. But it's interesting because you just released this album this month, but your album release party or concert won't be until October. Why is there a period of 3 months from the release date to the concert?
Actually, there is not a special reason that we choose the day in 28th of October. Mm. Maybe we want to have more time to prepare mm. for our show. Yeah, because we just don't want to let our audience to listen to a bunch of songs.
Yeah.
We want to take them to our gallery. So we are now testing and arranging our rundown. So we are really looking forward to see everyone on that day.
Very cool. I'm sure the audience would love to hear a song. I believe you're going to play a song for us that's not actually on this album. So tell me about the name of the song and what the song is about.
The song is Tomorrow's Town. Mm. The idea comes from the situation after war. Yeah, so afterwards, the town is like destroyed and broken family, broken buildings. Mm. I just want to deliver the picture, the image of that situation.
Cool. Well, I look forward to hearing it, and thank you all of you for coming in today.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.